Here's the shirt.
What the hell, man? What are we doing? Prateek, tell Grandma that he had nothing.
No, search thoroughly.
Ranveer?
Did you find anything? No. Oh, did you understand?
What is going on here?
Come on, Ranveer. Wear your clothes and come out. Come.
Dad, Grandma sent Devash and Prateek to frisk Ranveer. Dad, please stop them.
Mother, what is all this? Haven't I told you earlier never to doubt Ranveer, Mother? Still you...
Harshit, sir. Please, don't say anything to Grandma. Harshit, sir. Actually, a bracelet was stolen from Ishani's room. And I escorted her to her room last night. So obviously, Grandma is going to suspect me for stealing the bracelet.
Hey, I'm so sure you can never do this, Ranveer. You're with me since you were 14 years old. And accusing Ranveer and calling him a thief means calling me a thief. And the one whom I consider my biggest wealth, you accused him of stealing a bracelet, Mother? All the wealth and loads of money that I made in share market was because of his intelligence and brains, Mother. And will you ever understand? He is here only because of my love and not because of my money. He has a Midas touch, Mother. He can convert anything to gold with his touch. Hey, how can he steal gold? And that too of Ishani? Mother, he cares for Ishani as much as he cares for me.
Mother? Mother, just see what I found. I found 50,000 in Ranveer's room.
Ranveer can never steal, Mother. And I won't question Ranveer.
All right, so don't question him, okay? I will ask you a question. You said he did not steal. So then, how then did 50,000 come in this room? Those who don't even know how they are supposed to spend 500. 50,000 was found in their room. So then did you give a salary of 25,000 each to father and son?
Mother, I have
No, Harshad, you have said enough. Now you, listen to me. This blind trust that you have is not bigger than the honor of this family, Harshad. If Ishani's in-laws find out tomorrow that that small golden bracelet, that small little bracelet is missing, not you, but I will be disgraced. Understood?
Nothing of that sort will happen. I'm sorry. I know I shouldn't interfere in your family matters. Actually, I came to meet Sharman. But I heard you talking about the bracelet which my mom had given to Ishani. Actually, Ranveer didn't steal the bracelet. I took it from Ishani's room last night. You took it? Yes, uncle. I came here last night to meet Sharman. But by mistake, I went in Ishani's room. On the table, I saw the bracelet, which should have been on Ishani's wrist. I thought Ishani might feel the pressure of marriage because of the bracelet given as gift. And I don't want it that way. I want to accept Ishani with all my heart.
It's fine. You took the bracelet from Ishani's room. But you didn't leave money in Ranveer's room, did you? From where did the money come in his room?
All this is Ranveer's savings. The money that he saved all his lifetime. He had withdrawn it from the bank to give his mother. But
he was going to give it to Gauri. Chirag isn't just my friend, but Gauri's husband Romil's friend too. Romil told Chirag that his family drove Gauri and him out of the house. His brother doesn't want to give him his share. Now they both have no place to stay. So they are staying in a lodge. Ranveer learned everything when he saw them in the lodge. Ranveer was with them since morning. Gauri didn't want to take your help. So Ranveer tried to help them by giving them this money. Then he told me about this problem. So I brought them here.
Now you see, mother, you insulted him, calling him a thief and a servant. But as a family member, he helped the daughter of the house. But Ranveer, when you knew all this, why didn't you tell this before?
Harshad sir, actually, Gauri asked me not to tell this to anyone. That's why.
Now, if your reunion is over, then can we think of the rest? We talked a lot about the servants of the house. Now, can we talk about the daughter of this house? Her mother has gone on a pilgrimage, thinking that her daughter would be happy in this house. She doesn't know that her daughter has been driven out.
Harshad sir, I'll keep their luggage in the room.
Gauri, Roman, come with me.
Amba, listen to me.
I won't listen to anything. Now I won't stay here even for a minute.
Listen. But Amba, forget whatever happened.
After whatever happened, it's better to die. It's better to starve to death. It's better to commit suicide. They removed my son's clothes. Did I come to see all
Amba,
this?
If you go...
What?
Listen to me.
I'll always be at loggerheads with this house. When I came last time, ma'am insulted you. This time she insulted my son. You can bear to see this, but I can't see all this. If you want that I should stay here with you, then you have to find another job. I will not stay here.
Amba!
Mom! You won't go anywhere.
Are you saying this? You? In spite of whatever has happened?
You can see what Grandma did. But you ignored what Harshad sir did. Harshad sir hugged me in front of everyone. He didn't insult but honored me.
Use your brains, Ranveer, brains! He gives you so much of love only because he can slap you. He gives you these clothes so that he can remove them.
Mom, what are you talking?
She won't angry, son.
Father, you go. Harshad sir is getting late. I'll talk to mother. Mom, sit here. Please sit. Don't be stubborn. Look, and listen to me.
What do you have to say? You are still thinking about them only in spite of all that has happened. But did you ever think what your mother must be going through?
I know, Mom.
You don't know anything. Even a dog leaves a house after so much beating and abuses. But you don't want to leave this house. And they are taking undue advantage of this. But the day these people come to know the reason that you are not leaving this house, they will kick you out from here.
What do you mean?
Do you think? I don't know anything. I know everything. In this house, more than your loyalty, Ishani's love is stopped.
Not like the children of this house. But even you are educated. You are wise. By giving advice to your boss, you made him earn profit of millions. You can get any job very easily. And if you get a good job, then you'll also get a good girl in the village. Don't ruin your life for these people who make you a driver sometimes a porter. And when guests come, they make you butler also. You have no respect here. Those who strip your clothes, they can't be yours. Look, just mark my words today. The way money isn't loyal to the rich, rich people can't be friends with the poor. One day these people will drive you out of the house. It won't make any difference to them. They'll hire another servant in your place. But you, will you be able to brace yourself? Yeah? Can you forget this family and that girl? Will that be possible?
You are right, Mom. If I go to the village, I'll get a good job. I might even get a good girl. Everything will be fine.
Now tell me what has happened and why did you both not come here directly?
Uncle, we didn't want any issue in your family because of our family problem. And I felt my problem with my brother, I would solve by myself. So we didn't mention this to anyone.
I understand you, dear. But now even this family is yours and your problem is our problem, which will be solved by all of us together, okay?
Yes.
Let's do one thing. Let us invite your family tomorrow for dinner over here, okay?
But they...
Hey, first call them. Everything will be fine. Let them come.
I think it's better if you talk to them after a few days.
Okay. As you say. You should take some time and give them some time as well.
Okay.
Always remember one thing, son. This house is yours. You can stay here as long as you want, okay? Sharman, please show them their rooms. You both, why don't you take some rest?
Hey, Ranveer.
Yes?
Where did you keep Gauri's luggage?
It's still in the hall.
Then keep it in my room.
Yes.
No, Sharman. How can I stay in your room?
Hey Gauri, you should stay there. Sharman will stay in my room.
And where will I stay?
In the garage, because you can only fit there.
Hey, you can stay wherever you want. And remember, no matter how many days you stay here, you should be happy. Okay?
Yes, Gauri. I too can't bear to see you sad. That's why I brought chocolates for you.
chocolates help to rid away sadness. My chocolates?
Here it is.
Did you take chocolates out of my pocket?
Of course. If you eat so many chocolates, you will brought up more. We have to broaden the doors of the house.
Sharman.
Yes.
I have kept the luggage.
Okay.
Let's go.
What do you think of yourself? Do you think whatever you do is always right? Why didn't you tell Grandma that you went to meet Gauri and Roman? If you had told her, this would haven't happened. But of course you won't say anything, because you don't care about anything, you never feel hurt. But I do. You thought about Gauri, but you didn't think about me. You didn't think how bad I'll feel. Tell me.
Enough, enough, enough. And who told you? Who said nobody cares for me, huh? This flood of tears in Ishani Parekh's eyes indicates how much these girls care for me. Devash and Prateek didn't want to frisk me. They care for me. Harshad sir, trust me so much, he too cares for me. Okay, you tell me. If I had taken Gauri's name, would I have been able to see Ishani cry like this? Would sir have taken a stand for me in front of everyone? No. I'm not insulted in this house. On the contrary, I'm honored. Ishani, how many times do I have to tell you? Hey Pushpa, I hate tears.
Come on now, stop acting, okay? I know you felt bad. I have brought something to cheer you up.
What are you saying? You have brought something for me? What is it? Tell me. Sunny.
You like Sunny Leone's movies a lot, right?
Yes, but I even watch cartoons.
Really? When?
Every now and then. Whenever you cry, you look like a cartoon.